everybody! Today, we're going to explain the difference between coordinate and cumulative adjectives. My name is Ferny, and this is Lupita. Let's start. What are adjectives? Adjectives describes nouns and pronouns. It could be names, people, places, things, or ideas. If a word can answer any of these questions, what kind, which one, or how many, it is an adjective. To understand cumulative adjectives, you also need to understand coordinate adjectives. The main difference between them is the word order. In other words, where they are placed in a sentence.
Coordinate adjective can go before a noun or after a linking verb. But what is a linking verb? The most common linking verbs are the verb to be in all tenses, the verb become and seem. For example, our English textbook is boring. The word English is a coordinate adjective before textbook, that is a noun. Is the linking verb, and boring is the other coordinate adjective after the linking verb. Coordinate adjectives have equal weight. If there is more than one coordinate adjective in the sentence, you can reverse the adjectives and still make sense. The order of the adjectives doesn't matter. But they always need a comma. Let's see now another example. The Coldplay concert was cheap, crazy, funny, and incredible because all the fans were enjoying it. Now, we're gonna diagram it. First, we'll find the main clause, the one that makes more sense. In this example will be the Coldplay concert was cheap, crazy, funny, and incredible. Now, let's identify the subject, that is concert, then the linking verb, that is the verb to be in past tense. Now we have the and Coldplay. Those are coordinate adjectives because they are before the noun. Here note, the is an article, but it answers the questions which concert and answers the Coldplay concert. That is why it is working as an adjective as well as Coldplay. Then the other coordinate adjective that go after the linking verb, cheap, crazy, funny, and incredible. All these adjectives can change their order and the sentence will continue making sense. Also notice that they are describing the same noun. That is why we are diagramming like this. Let's continue the other clause, that is a subordinating clause because it starts with a subordinating conjunction. So, all the fans were enjoying is the subordinating clause, where fan is the subject that is a noun. Then, were enjoying is the verb phrase where is the auxiliary and enjoying the main verb. All and the are the coordinating adjectives because they modify the subject phrase. Also, in this clause, we have a direct subject, that is it, which is referring to the concert. Direct object answers the question, what were the fans enjoying? The concert that is equal to it.
Now that we understand coordinate adjectives, let's take a look at cumulative adjectives. Cumulative adjectives must go before a noun. Unlike coordinating adjectives, cumulative adjectives do not use a comma because they work as a team. They are like steps and they need an order. For example, the game showed new several young players. This sentence is incorrect. New and several cannot go in this order. They need to work as a group. The sentence must be, the game show several new young players. The order of the cumulative adjectives goes like this. First, the articles, demonstrative pronouns, and the possessive adjectives. Then, adjectives of quantity, of opinion, appearance, the age or color, the nationality or the religion, material purpose, and finally a noun used as an adjective. Let's go for another long example. My 41 great young ELT classmate have many questions about grammar class because they have a quiz on Monday. To diagram it, we must find the main clause. That is, my 41 great young ELT classmates have many questions about grammar class. The subject of this clause is the noun classmates, and the verb is have in present tense. Let's check if the order is correct. We have my as possessive, 41 of quantity, great as appearance, young as age, and ELT as a noun used as an adjective. To continue, the cumulative adjectives are diagrammed in this way because ELT is describing the word classmates. Young is describing the ELT classmates. Great is describing young ELT classmates. 41 is describing the great 41 ELT classmates. And the possessive adjective my is describing the 41 great young ELT classmates. Now, question is a direct object answering what my 41 great young ELT classmates have. Question. And many is the adjective describing the noun question. But which questions? The ones about grammar class. So, about is a preposition, and class is the object of the preposition, and it makes a prepositional phrase. And grammar is the adjective answering which class? The grammar class. Next, we're going to diagram the other clause that it is also a subordinating clause. And it starts with the subordinating conjunction because. Because they have a quiz on Monday. They is the subject, a personal pronoun. Have is the verb in present tense. And what they have? A quiz. So it is a direct object. And A, the article describing which quiz. On Monday is a prepositional phrase of time, so it goes under the verb as an adverb. All the examples that we use are complex sentences because they have a main clause and a subordinating clause.
Now, just to conclude, let's remember what we said today. Adjectives describe nouns and pronouns. Coordinate adjectives go before a noun and after a linking verb. When we have many adjectives, their order doesn't matter, and they need to be separated by a comma.
Cumulative adjectives go before a noun and they work as a group. They need an order and they do not need commas.
Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.
Now we have the and couplet. Those are coordinate adjectives because they are before the noun. Here note the. Where they are placed in a sentence.
Tú síguele, 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 síguele.